Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson.
Ruby Vishnick is in studio with All Things Entertainment.
Thanks, guys. I am Posh Spice today. Jay-Z is to headline a concert for Hilary Clinton in Cleveland before Election Day. The event is part of an ongoing series of concerts that aims to motivate young people to turn out for Clinton the way they turned out for Obama in 2008 and 2012. Jay-Z's event is targeted specifically at young black voters, an electoral demographic that has been reluctant to rally around Clinton, which has been seen to be due to the comments she made in the 90s and her support of President Bill Clinton's crime bill. Jay-Z is not the first member of his household to help Clinton. Beyonce attended a Clinton fundraiser in New York City in 2015. However, she has not yet performed on Clinton's behalf. Jay-Z has been slow to back Clinton, especially considering how close he has been with Obama. This concert solidifies his endorsement of Clinton for president. It's too bad for Donald Trump that his Secret Service protection doesn't extend to his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. A vandal took a hammer and pickaxe to the center of the reality TV personality turned presidential candidate star near the Dolby Theater on Hollywood. On Hollywood Boulevard before dawn on Wednesday. Both Trump's name and the camera icon on the center stage were damaged beyond recognition. The Hollywood Chamber of Commerce president and CEO, Laurent Gubler, has said that Trump's star is to be replaced immediately. Trump has proclaimed that once the election is over, the person responsible for this is going to be sued. On Monday, Drake released a few brand new tracks on Apple Music. One of these songs is catching particular attention for all the wrong reasons. On the track titled Two Birds, One Stone, Drake disses fellow rapper Kid Cudi because of his struggle with mental health illness. He raps, "You were the man on the moon, now you go through your phases. Life of the angry and famous, rap like I know I'm the greatest and give you the tropical flavors. Still never been on hiatus and stay zan and perked up when reality set in, you don't gotta face it." Earlier this month, Cudi announced that he was checking himself into rehab in order to deal with a severe anxiety and depression. His candid admission was met with overwhelming support. However, it seems that this support for Cudi went over Drake's head. There's been speculation that the Canadian rapper has most likely getting back at Cudi for a Twitter rant in September, where he accused both Drake and Kanye of being fake rappers. But while Kanye has already squashed the beef, Drake decided to take shots at Cudi, but calling his mental health issues problems a phase isn't great. Fans have taken to Twitter to show their upset. Drake has yet to comment on the incident. Lady Gaga is the most recent star to appear on Carpool Karaoke with James Corden on The Late Late Show. Gaga came ready to belt, harmonize, and do some fabulous synchronized chair dancing. The car ride included Gaga classics such as Bad Romance and Edge of Glory, as well as one of her newer songs, Perfect Illusion. Corden sported some of Gaga's classic looks in the car. Let's take a look.
Kind of the point is to be unfashionable.
See, I thought you looked great in this outfit. I thought this was particularly strong for you.
I mean, I think I looked all right in that look.
Now, which outfits are your favorites where you think, oh, that's beautiful?
I mean, my favorite was the McQueen dress that I wore to the VMAs. It was the same year I wore the meat dress, but I wore that earlier in the night.
The good thing with this one is you've always got a snack.
Okay.
You need it.
Okay.
You just, oh, I'm hungry. Gaga, look at me.
Corden and Gaga really committed to this one. We here at GME can't wait to see what star will be next on the show. I'm Ruby Vishnick, and that's it for entertainment this week. Now back to Sean and Claire at the demo table.